Trust it.
Hey everybody, Dr. O here. Welcome to the skeletal system. So what is the skeletal system? It is all the bones of the skeleton plus the connective tissues, the cartilage and ligaments and stabilizing tissues that hold it all together. So when you think of the skeletal system, let's go ahead and talk about the primary functions. You probably think of support and structure and these kind of things, and that's a big deal, but there are some other ones as well. So support is the first function of the skeletal system. I like to think of, if you didn't have the skeleton, you'd basically be a puddle on the ground, and that's because your skeleton is what gives you your frame. Number two, you know, sticking with support, we have this idea of protection. You have your ribs protecting your lungs, your sternum protecting your heart, these types of things. So protection, you have your skull protecting your brain. So support, protection, and then leverage or movement. So we'll cover the muscular system next, but your muscles couldn't do anything. Muscles just shorten. How they, the fact that they create force and generate movement is because of where they are attached on your bones. So support, protection, and leverage are probably the three that people think of the most often with your skeletal system. But we also have storage and then blood cell production. So for storage, we have storage of minerals. When you think of the minerals in your skeletal system, you should think calcium first. About 99% of your body's calcium is stored in your bones, but there are lots of other minerals stored in your bones as well. Molybdenum, boron, a whole host of them. So mineral storage, and we'll come back to that in just a moment, but then also some lipid storage. So we don't think about this, but a lot of our bones, once we've reached adulthood, are full of yellow marrow. They're full of fat. That's why dogs love bones so much. They try to break them open to get into this kind of fatty treat. So there's a little bit of lipid storage. I think that's pretty minor. But mineral storage, very big deal. We'll come back to that in just a moment. And then lastly, we have blood cell production. So the one that people forget the most often is the fact that inside your bone we have red bone marrow, which is where your blood cells are produced. So support, protection, leverage, those are the physical traits of these tough bones that we have. But then there's also storage, especially mineral storage, and then we have the blood cell production. Okay, a couple more things here. Let's talk about the two types of marrow just one more time here. You do see red marrow is going to be where hematopoiesis or blood cell production takes place. We'll cover that in AMP2. Yellow marrow is going to be fat. So when you're a kid, all your bone marrow is going to be red, and then slowly it transitions into yellow marrow, except for the epiphyses or the ends of your long bones, and then some of these flat bones like you see here, the ilium, the head of the femur, which is an epiphysis, and the scapula still have, and your ribs, these kind of places would still have red marrow in adulthood. That's why if they're going to do a bone marrow biopsy or transplant, they usually go right there into the ilium to get it. So my father gave bone marrow to his brother and they dipped into his ilium to get that bone marrow. But the first thing I think of, and we talk about this more in nutrition, but the first thing I think about with bones is the calcium, right? You see bones and you want big, strong, healthy bones. Your body sees a calcium storage depot. So when you think of the functions of calcium, making strong, healthy bones is actually the least of your body's worries. And that's because your body is constantly trying to keep you alive right now. I like to look at it this way. Your body's trying to maintain homeostasis for the next 5 seconds, then the next 5 seconds, then the next 5 seconds. So having, I'm 41 now, having strong bones into my 80s would be great, but my body has to use calcium for so many other things now that's more important. Every muscle contraction requires calcium. Neurotransmitter release, so every time a nerve fires, calcium is needed. Calcium is needed for balancing pH issues and all sorts of things. So your body will make strong bones if there's more than enough calcium. If there's not, then your bones are going to have to be sacrificed. Your bones are going to get weaker a little bit every day as your body constantly has to dip into them and take the calcium out. All right, so that's red and yellow marrow. Last just introductory thing that I think of when it comes to the skeleton is how all our bones are so different, but it's because they all have a unique job to do, right? So every bone has a particular function and its structure is going to be built for that. Like if you look at like a lumbar vertebrae in your low back, it's going to be much bigger and denser and thicker than a cervical vertebrae. Well, a cervical vertebrae's primary job is to allow for lots of movement. It doesn't have to support a lot of weight, even if you have a huge head like I do. But a lumbar vertebrae is not going to allow for near as much movement, but it's going to have to support all of my body weight that's at least above my waist. Or you think about like your femur, your big leg bone is going to be much bigger and have larger attachment points for bigger muscles than the bones of your arm, because our legs have to be stronger than our arms because we carry our body weight around. So I think that's plenty for now. This is the skeletal system. I hope you learn a lot. Like we'll look at bone as a tissue first, and then we'll go through the two parts of the skeleton, our axial skeleton and our appendicular skeleton. So let's dive in. I hope this helps. Have a wonderful day. Be blessed.